you and I have a problem, and I'm not talking about the coronavirus, at least not directly. I'm talking about something else. 6 weeks ago, many Americans retreated into their home, and many states implemented executive orders closing businesses across the country. And now now that I'm recording this, they're starting to reopen, but even then, only partially, like my business, which is open to members only. So this is going on all over the country, right? This is going all over the world. And what does it mean exactly? The economic crisis is real. The IMF has already officially said this is the greatest downturn since the Great Depression. And in the US history, it's hard to top that. Those countries, like parts of China, that are now reopening after the threat of the coronavirus has passed, are experiencing what The Economist calls the 90% economy, where things are sort of back, but people are still reluctant to go out. There's a lot of businesses that are still closed to the public, and so that's changing a lot of things about daily life. It's weird, there's pieces missing, and it also means there's a lot of money being left out of circulation. Jerome Powell, the chair of the Federal Reserve in the US, is officially to come out to say that the technical term for the current economic crisis is heartbreaking. Now, it may come as no surprise to you, but Federal Reserve chairmen are not hired for their hearts. So, what's an entrepreneur to do? Your business is closed? You're looking at things like GDP and unemployment rates and you're like, okay, that doesn't look good, but what does that mean for me? And that's what I've been wrestling with and asking a lot of entrepreneurs, business owners, and advisors about over the last few weeks to try to wrap my head around it. And so I've determined what I think are the three first things that you can do, that I'm doing myself too, to adapt your business to the new economy. So there's three things to get you started. You can do this. The first thing you need to do is fix your finances, because the reality is, this is always true, but it's especially true right now, that you need to make sure you have clear visibility and also just clear cash flow in terms of how money is coming in and coming out of your business. Right now, your first priority is to survive. And so the resource that I use for this, that I recommend, is the book Profit First by Mike Michalowicz. And he also has a lot of great resources on his website for this, as do I. I'll link to my article about Profit First in the description of this video. But it's a really important concept, because it's this whole idea of saying that you're making decisions about how you should spend money in your business based on money you actually have. And that's really important when things happen like a lockdown or a crisis, where all of a sudden all of that money is tightened and shrunk, right? So you have a lot less to work with. So step one is to fix your finances. The second thing you can do to adapt your business to the new economy is to empathize with your audience. I mean, think about what they're going through right now, because we're all going through some version of a crisis right now, and that includes your potential customers. So this is where I find it helpful to actually go back to Psychology 101 and revisit Abraham Maslow's hierarchy of needs. And this is this pyramid that walks through the different ways in which people approach their life. Now, normally, people are at different levels of the hierarchy of needs, right? So some people are really successful, and so they're really thinking about some of the upper echelon things like, you know, respect, self-actualization, becoming the best version of themselves. But right now, everyone just got knocked down to the bottom of the pyramid, and that starts with physiological needs. In other words, first, do you have food, water, and toilet paper, right? That's the need right now. But as soon as that need is met, the next thing is to take care of your safety needs. Do you have income? Do you have shelter? Do you have the things that you need to stay safe and to keep your family safe, right? So that's where everyone is they're in this transition of, once they have those needs met, then they can think about love and belonging. Where do they belong in the world? Do they have friends and family that support them in a community? Well, I'm just gonna X out the rest of that, because the reality is nothing else in this pyramid is relevant right now, because everybody's down at the bottom moving up. So empathize with your audience and make sure you're talking in your language, when how you talk to them in your marketing, make sure that you're acknowledging the real crisis of where they're at, empathizing with them, and using that as a lens for how you communicate. And the third thing to do is simply to sell solutions to real problems that real people have. That's all the business is. As an entrepreneur, what you do is you create solutions, right? You create real solutions to real problems for real people. That is how you succeed in business. So right now, compared to 6 or 8 weeks ago, or 2 months ago, three months ago, do you think people have more problems or less problems? And specifically, think about the people in your audience. What problems do they have right now that you can help solve? And this is your opportunity to create products or services to help serve them. So this may mean throwing your entire business plan that you've had out the window and just starting saying, like, today's day one. What do I wanna do? Who do I wanna help, and how do I wanna help them? And this is your chance to do that. And that is what I believe is going to make the difference in terms of those businesses that survive and thrive in the new economy are those that go through these this three-step process in whatever way you do that to make sure that you first take care of your fixing your finances, and then you empathize with your audience about where they're at, and then you sell real solutions. If you do that, I believe you're going to be part of the group that succeeds and survives and thrives in this and adapts the new economy, and we need you to do it. Honestly, we all need you to create real solutions because we all have problems. So keep up the good work and let me know in the comments what you end up doing and how this ends up affecting your trajectory, because I want to see you succeed. And I'm right here with you in the trenches, making the same changes to my own business, to adapt my own business to this new economy. And I look forward to see what we can do together. No economist worth his Bitcoin. Is that too cryptic? What? Okay. What's going on in your business? Where the bell has rung.